Okay, here we go. We're going to have a little bit of a closer look at this Linux distro, Zorin 17.2 Pro. A little bit about the device I'm using is I'm using a Dell Inspiron 7370. It has 8 gigabytes of RAM. It's running an i5 processor. You can see here it's running 256 gigs of storage. And again, it's running Zorin OS 17.2 Pro. Well, I work in an office environment, and what I want to do is, well, in an office environment, probably the two primary apps that I use is the word processor and a spreadsheet app. So first I want to take a look is, I'm going to go to the office here, and let's dig in. Zorin 17.2 comes with LibreOffice Writer, so I'm going to go ahead and open that up. And I did create a couple of files just to get started with, so I wouldn't be spending all day typing something out. Let's take a look. I'm just going to go ahead here and open. Got a couple of files here, so I'm going to go with Unboxing with Marty. So let's open that one up. All right, so here you go. Hey, you can see I made some spelling mistakes. So let's just correct a couple, just to see how you can see how it works. You can see right here, it's telling me your underlined speechless here is underlined in red. So I'm going to right-click. It's going to tell me how to respell it. And just by right-clicking and selecting, I can correct that. Let's try another one. Let's see what else. Let's just try this one, YouTube. I'm going to go ahead and I right-clicked on it. See again, right-click. Gives me some choices. So I'm going to go with this. And there you go. I'm not going to worry about the rest of the spelling here. I just wanted a demo and see how it works. You know what I want to do is I'm going to add a little bit of a header here. So let's just call it, I heard there's a really good YouTube channel out there. Hold on. How's that? Let's see how that works. So we're going to do that. Unboxing with Marty. And I'm going to highlight that. I'm going to move it out to the center. There you go. Just by clicking here. I'm going to increase the font. Let's just make it big. And let's make it bold. Got it. You see how this is working. So the next thing what I want to do is I'm going to throw a picture in here just for fun. Let's go. We can do it two ways. One, well, first one I want to show you is here in files, I have two sets of pictures here. Let's take a look. All right. So pictures taken with my iPhone. You can see them right there. Of course, I can open them up right here. You got that? And just to be fair, I also, yeah, I have one of those really old Kodaks, but I took a picture of this iMac, and there you go. So I'm going to use those as samples. And the reason I'm using two different samples is, I'll show you, hold on. So I'm going to insert a picture. Let's go to insert. We're going to go with an image. And yeah, you can see here, here's the trick here. As you can see here in Kodak, in the Kodak directory, you can see it recognizes the pictures. But we're going to go to the IMAX. It can't see them. So there's a compatibility issue there. But there is a workaround. So first things first, let's go back to pictures. We're going to go back to Kodak because we know you can see those. So I'm just going to grab this one just for the heck of it. I'm going to go ahead and put it in there. Wow, that's a pretty big, but I'm going to shrink it down here. Let's slide this down. There you go. And we'll just slide it a little bit over there. So there you get the idea. There is a workaround on how to get those photos taken with my iPhone. So give me a minute here. We're going to go back down here to files. Let's navigate to the iMac pictures. I like this one. Let's just open it. Well, let's left click and open it up. And then what I'm going to do is, where did I find that? There should be a copy here. Here it is. Copy right there. So I'm going to copy it. Let's just shrink it down so we can see what we're doing. And let's paste it. Oop, it comes in big again. So we're just going to shrink it down. But you can see we do have a workaround. So I'm setting the iPhone picture in there as well. There you go. Let's just slide this over a little bit. Just make it a little bit better. And we'll slide it down a little bit. There you go. So the next thing I want to do is let's just go ahead and print this. So go down here to print. Sees the printer. We're just going to print the one page and give it a second to come off of the printer. And I'll be right back. Hold on. All right, so we've completed that document. I'm going to go ahead and close this out. I'm not going to save it because, again, we were just trying to have some fun here. But you know what I want to do is I want to scan it in now. We're going to try the scanning because, you know, at home offices, you're going to want to scan occasionally. So I'm just going to type in scan because I want to find the app that's going to take care of it. Here we go. Document scanner. Let's load it up. Let's see. Searching for scanners. Give it a minute. Here we go. So I'm going to go ahead and scan it away. Let's do it. It's going to take a moment. I can hear the scanner move around over there. There it is. Let's just save it. Scan document. Save. There you go. And we don't need this anymore either. So let's take a look here. Let's see what we got here. And there's your scanned document. So we've taken care of that. So as far as a word processor, the word processor that comes with Zorin 17.2 Pro seems to be adequate. So next, we're going to take a look at the spreadsheet. So now let's take a look at the spreadsheet app that comes with Zorin 17.2 Pro. Let's take a look. We're going to go back in the office supplies. Again, it comes with LibreOffice. We're going to go to LibreOffice Calc. We're going to open it up. And as you can see, it looks like a typical spreadsheet app. So what I want to do is I did create a file to save us time. Let's just call, I called it budget. We're going to go ahead and open it up. And there you go. So you got roughly, well, you can see we're coming down to the line 37. You got a header line. So you have basically 36 records here. And basically a simple budget is made up. You got income, groceries, gas. You got it. So what I want to do is we're going to go down south and take a look here. And we're going to use this function. And let's just go with sum. Hit the enter. And there's your total. Let's try something else just for fun while we're at it. So what we'll do is we're going to go back here. Let's count. 36 records, just like I said. So you kind of get the idea. It's pretty easy to use. Let's see what else we can do here. Let's see. Data. Let's see if we have auto filter. There you go. So let's just say if you wanted to take a look, you have these choices of your filters. We're going to uncheck all. Let's just see what the income was. And so hit OK. Got it. You know, one of the tricks I do is you can always just drag down like that and you're going to get your average and you're going to get your total right there. That's just a quick trick there. Let's see how this works here. So I'm going to select my sum, hit enter. 4,500. And again, we can just double check it this way. Down here, you got 4,500. And like I said, here you got the average. Let's just test the average for fun. Why not? All right. So then we're going to go here, go with average, hit the enter key, and bang, there you go, 375. Well, they're all 375. It's pretty obvious what the average is. All right. So there you got an idea. That's kind of neat. Let's see what else we can do here. Let's get rid of the filters, data, and oh, let me go over here. Turn off the auto filters. There you go. You know, something that I use a lot. Let's just try that. Insert data, pivot table. There. So I'm going to bring the name down here and I'm going to bring the amount over here. And you know what? And then I'm going to bring the date over here and hit OK. Look at that. Now you got a pivot table. Get the idea? That's just another way to organize your data. So let's give you a good idea here. So that tells me that, yes, I could use the spreadsheet. Again, you know, I've only looked at this a few times, so I'm not an expert with it. You know, so love to fly through this more, but like I said, spent just a little time studying the spreadsheet app. So let's close this out. I'm not going to save. Let's see what else can we have a look at. Oh, you know what? Here's something that's always important. As a home user, I'm going to look up the firewall. You can also just use your search feature here. Yeah, you could look for it if you wanted to, but I'm going to click here. You got to click key in your password. And it's going to bring up your firewall. So right now it's off, but I'm going to go ahead and turn it on. Some may debate that you do or do not need a firewall with Linux. That's your decision. You know, I kind of, pardon the phrase, I grew up with Windows, so I like to have a firewall turned on. They make it available, so I'm going to go ahead and turn it on. So the firewall's on. Let's see. Well, you know what? One more last thing is, we've already looked at it before, but let's just dig in. Let's look at the browser. You know, obviously, yes, the browser, it's something that's a given, but let's see, double click on, I didn't click on it enough maybe. Let's get that to come up, there you go. And what we want to do is with the browser, really, let's see, we'll go to bookmarks. I probably saved some here to save us time. The browser itself, so yes, you could obviously, depending on your email service, if you have a browser-driven email service, you could always just access your email through your browser. So that makes it pretty simple. I think at that point in time, I mean, this was just a very short but kind of a deeper dive into the usability and the functionality of the, like I said, the Linux distro Zorin 17.2 Pro. Again, this experiment here was just to see if, yes, can I, out of the box, use Zorin 17.2 Pro on a reasonably good laptop and use it on a day-to-day basis. It looks like from this view that, yes, it will fill my needs if I want to use this as my primary driver. So I hope this video was a benefit to you. If it was, please be sure to subscribe to this channel. And if you like this video, you can always click that like button too, because, you know, likes are always good. And as always, I appreciate you viewing the video. And as always, thank you and have a good day.